Greetings, fellow woodlings. Welcome back to Pink Panther and Passport to Peril. We are currently in Egypt and we are looking for a solution to the Egyptian ghouls problem. I don't exactly know. I forgot the name, essentially. And, it's apparently so hot here that this camel is dead. And we also have a scorpion right off the bat. There also seems to be quite a bit of heat, as you can see. Mirages in the distance, or at least I suppose that is what these are supposed to be, given the glorious 16-bit graphics. Anyhow, I mean, the game got upscaled to 1920 without any issues, so I suppose that's all I can ask for. I wonder if these are vector graphics, and that is the reason why all of this is possible. That would explain the low quality images, in my opinion, but anyhow. That camel is not dead. I stand corrected. That camel is in fact broken down. And we got a scorpion that squeaks. How nice.
I need to find the mouth of the Nile.
Lucy will tell you that's me. Get your camels here! The only way to get away is sand too hot to walk, my friends. Try a four-legged companion. I'm crazy. I'm the mouth of the Nile and I will make a nice deal for you. Today only.
That's very funny. I'm looking for a girl.
Aren't we all, my friend? Aren't we all? Bring her a souvenir, she will never forget you. How about this one?
My panther went to Egypt and all he brought me was this crummy t-shirt.
Damn. You've got very specific merchandise, don't you? And there's a horse.
What's
here
with the three legs?
She cut herself shaving. But I tell you, that one leg in the front is like iron.
Cut herself shaving her legs, huh?
Yikes! What's that?
Probably a sand mummy.
A sand mummy?
Don't you know anything about mummification?
Now, the ancient Egyptians had a way to preserve a body for the afterlife. Embalming a body was the way to begin, and for that you need a ritual nerve. Excavation went through. A Brit named Palacana found his underground hut. Oh! When making a mummy, you need a clean shell. Scoop the brains through the nose. That's the best way, I suppose. A mummy mask, part of the burial task, can be made to resemble a young fellow's face. Mummification is the preservation of a body. Dry out the skin, then you remove what's within. Then you're ready for the afterlife. Oh, mummification is the preservation of a body that's no longer alive. You dry out the skin, then you remove what's within. Then you're ready for the afterlife. Yeah! Mummification, yeah, is a preservation.
Some mummies are mummified with a procedure called embalming. That's what the ancient Egyptians did. But there are other kinds of naturally preserved mummies, like sand mummies.
So if you just drop a body in the sand, it mummifies naturally?
Yep.
Yeesh.
Technically, any dead body that still has skin on it is a mummy.
Where did you learn so much about this?
From my mummy.
Thanks for the lesson, Mouth. I guess I better get out of here before I mummify.
Okay, do you want to try and give this mummy a high five? I don't think so. Right. I just noticed all of these guys have four fingers on each hand.
Oh, who loves the tourist baby? Mouth does. Make a nice deal today only. The heat must have got me. Stop me, Lucy. I'm crazy.
So panthers, they can walk on the sand. Cats, I mean, in general. They have protection against bones underneath the paws, from what I remember, if I recall correctly. There's a hawker right here.
Kebab?
No Pink Panther, but if I run into Kebab, I'll tell him you're looking for him.
Funny. Try kebab, lamb or beef. Tahini or no?
I don't have any money.
But you have a lovely pink smile, and my heart cannot say no. Say, why don't we barter? You get me, say, a rug, and I'll give you the grub.
I'll see what I can do.
A rug for grub is a very expensive trade, not a fair trade at all. We've got some folks here.
Do you know a girl named Chione?
No.
Ask the owner. He knows everyone.
I'm guessing that's the owner since we got into the building.
Do you know a girl named Chione?
Strombone? Crazy one-eyed Strombone? Please, sit and have coffee with me. Tell me your story about Strombone. Crazy Strombone. It's been years. Ziada, masputa, or sada?
Sorry?
Sweet. Medium or bitter?
Sweet, medium, or bitter what?
Coffee! How do you like it? Sweet, medium, or bitter?
Oh, sweet.
Yonder, two!
Decaf, if you have.
So tell me, when did you first meet Strombone?
Ooh, is this a funny story? Okay, Strombone and I first met, I think it was... Actually, I haven't really met Strombone per se. I mean, I have heard stories about Strombone, but this is gonna be our first real meeting. You know what I mean?
So you don't know Strombone?
No. Who do any of us really know?
I know Strombone.
Well, I think you misunderstood me. I said I was looking for Chione.
I don't know her.
That's okay. Well, thanks for the coffee. Zia delicious.
Well, you put a hot cup of coffee right in there, alright. Alright. There's a pack mule right here, and...
Should we send Chione a little care package?
Ooh.
Maybe a piece of jewelry?
The director of Camp Frilly Chacha asked us not to send anything other than letters.
We could send it in a letter!
Your daughter is away at camp?
Yeah, she's away. Thank goodness. She is a handful.
She's two handfuls.
Always boating to a farming village in Upper Egypt, no matter how many times I ask her not to bother people working. It's the sake she loves. Always begging to drive the ox.
It's no way for a little girl to behave.
Have you heard from her? I mean, is she enjoying herself at camp?
We expect to hear from her today.
I see. Well, best of luck. I hope she's having fun.
But she's not. So maybe she's a upriver in the camp. Maybe we should inform the scientist about it.
This may sound like a silly question, but...
Do I have a magic lamp? You just saw Aladdin, and you're looking for your very own genie, complete with a name, voice, talent. Welcome to reality. There's no three witches. There's no Robbie Williams. There's plain brass pots and hot sun. What can I get you?
Nothing. Thanks.
Cynic.
There actually was a genie in that. He just got released.
Assalamu alaikum. Colorful carpet, not too dusty.
Does it fly?
That cost extra.
Well, it's not for me, it's for a friend.
Ooh.
The kebab vendor.
Oh, Fatouche. He's been trying to get a rug to sit on for weeks. You tell Fatouche he can have that rug for that cup of coffee he was supposed to treat me to.
I see. So that's what the coffee is for. I suppose it's his friends taking care of each other.
Fresh coffee from Fatouche?
Sensational! What kind of rug would Tushy like? I have every style, every shape, every fabric, every size, everything!
Everything?
Absolutely everything!
Okay, how about a Pink Panther skin rug?
Dear.
Hey!
What? It's synthetic!
So I see. Alright, time to get him. The Pink Panther, synthetic Pink Panther skin rug. And let's see. I wonder what use the kebab has. Why is he going all around the place? Panther? No.
Well, here's your rug. I hope you like it.
And now for your grub.
Oh, when the rug vendor says he'll buy you a cup of coffee next.
Now, what do we use the kebab with? Like, this piece is just a bare bones, I...
Could I borrow one of your camels? I need to get to the banks of the Nile.
Not for nothing you can't. The camel ride will cost you.
I'm a businessman. I live to sell, I sell to live. I have a three-legged pony to provide for, and I haven't even had lunch today. I'm crazy!
Well, fine. I'll just find my own way there.
Now we give him the kebab. Which is hardly filling, but we'll go.
I've got a kebab.
10 kebab. 8 kebab.
I only have one.
7 kebabs.
I only have one.
6 kebabs, my final offer.
I only have one.
Sold! You drive a hard bargain, Panther. You're lucky I'm hypoglycemic. Give me the grub. Okay, that was somewhat delicious. Now get me a rug, and we'll be on our way.
A rug?
My camel's hump has been sitting in the hot sun all day. You can't expect me to ride on it bare.
Ma'asal salama, Pink. That means so long.
Now we need to get him a rug. How do we get him a rug? Can't exactly.
Who loves the tourist baby? Mouth does make a nice deal today only. The heat must have got me. Stop me, Lucy, I'm crazy.
I wonder who this Lucy composed this.
Remember that rug I gave you?
Yes. Truth be told, it kind of gives me the creeps.
Well, I'd be happy to take it off your hands.
He wants it back, does he? Just as soon as he buys me the coffee he promised.
Alright, I guess we get some more coffee.
You must really like coffee.
Yes, I do.
Nice to see you again.
Now, where can I get the coffee?
You must really like coffee.
Yes, I do.
Any chance I can bother you for another rug?
Did Fatouche send you? Tell him he gets one rug only. That's all. And by the way, this coffee is lukewarm.
Well, that makes it a job easier. You trade and stuff, and then you trade back. You send stuff back, but except you don't really get what you came for.
Here's your coffee. I hope you like it, Ziada.
I do.
Alright, so somebody's losing out right now. Alright, we have a rug.
Oh, famine. Famine. The sand is closing in on me. I have not eaten in 100 days and 100 nights.
or at least since this morning. Yes, Lucy, I'm anxious to get going too, but the hump is too hot. Perhaps the panther will prevail. Why, Pink, I didn't notice you. Any luck?
Okay, Mouth. You wanted food, I brought you food. You wanted a rug, I brought you a rug.
Creepy.
I've done everything you've asked. Now would you please help me get to the banks of the Nile?
Absolutely, my friend. Absolutely. Just as soon as I quench my raging thirst.
Oh, brother.
I like it, Ziada, my friend. We'll leave as soon as you return.
I see.
Parched!
We need to get the
like
coffee
a piece
again.
Of old paper. Drier than my mother-in-law's rump roast. My throat is the desert. The desert is my throat. I am no one until my insatiable thirst is quenched.
I really thought he was going to say try that my mother's something else there. Anyhow, time to get the coffee back then.
I'm about to try it now. It's lukewarm.
Well, I guess we'll just let those two guys settle their differences.
Liquid, lovely liquid. Just the way I like it, lukewarm.
This guy really...
It won't be long now, my friends, until we all drink from the banks of the Nile. Hurrah!
But that camel has sort of broken down, hasn't it? That's an Egyptian mythological ship right there. Okay, new puzzle section. That... Who knows who that is? There's a croc.
Oh, hello. I was going to take a dip, but I'll check back later.
Well, what happened to three-legged Lucy? And how did her leg change sides?
And now, Panther, please, some food for my Lucy.
I don't have any food. I gave you what I had. You ate it.
No provisions for my Lucy? After such a long journey? I'm afraid we must terminate our relationship with you. I'm sorry. Don't talk to us anymore.
Mouth, please.
Did you hear something, Lucy? I heard nothing. I'm not listening to you.
That guy... I believe is quite like an Egyptian merchant.
Have you seen a little girl about so high, dark hair?
Yes, I have.
Daddy!
I see. Are you making a boat?
Yes, I am. Out of papyrus reeds.
I really need to travel further into Upper Egypt. Can I borrow your boat?
No, my panther, you've got to get your own. Or hitch a ride with them.
What's funny?
Nothing.
I guess it's back to Cairo.
Oh, we can do that, huh? We click on the camel to travel back and forth. There's a new guy in the scene here.
Why so sad, my friend?
My friend Mouth is mad at me.
Ah, you know Mouth? Do me a favor. When you see Mouth, give him this.
What's this?
The Eye of Horus.
protects you from evil spells. He's been waiting for one. I had it on back order. Now tell me, what can I do for you?
I think you may have just saved a little girl's life. Thanks.
If you see her, tell her I said hi.
Because he needs food for Lucy.
Brass here! Brassy, brassy, brass! Brass of brass!
I guess we can try this guy then.
I know someone who is looking for one of those. A guy named Mouth.
And we give him that and he's gonna be okay to travel with us. I suppose. Okay, time to give this mouth.
Probably won't make a difference to you, but this is from Fadil.
The Eye of Horus. I've been waiting for this baby. Increases your sales drive. Okay, Lucy, you can wear it.
Thanks for delivering that. Here's a little scarab for your troubles.
Now what do we do with the scarab there? Look at that guy back inside the water there.
I can't swim that far.
Of course you can, but you're just afraid of the water, aren't you? There's more to this area, apparently. Interesting. Is that it? I suppose that's their way of telling us that we actually need... What's his name? The camel here to travel back and forth. Doubt the scarab is gonna convince
I'm
this guy.
I'm flattered, but I only think of you as a friend.
I see. And Lucy's too busy crying. I don't know what for. Most likely for the other donkey. Alright. Let us then head back into town and get the donkey
to
scarab.
I guess it's back to Cairo.
These puzzles are a confirmed thing, to say the least. Ah, yes, of course. He now has flowers in his mouth.
Oh, I was hoping I'd see you again. If you see Lucy, will you give her these?
Thanks, Cuckoo. I bet she'll really like them.
Oh, I don't wear jewelry. Or fancy clothes. I don't drive an expensive cart. You don't happen to have a tuna on rye.
I get it, you're hungry as well. That guy, maybe?
Brass here! Brassy, brassy, brass! Brass of brass!
What about you? Would you have, Nothing, he just chooses away. Alright then. I thought, since that guy said I only think of you as a friend, I thought that probably means that, you know, it's, supposed to be something exchanged between lovers, but I suppose we give this Lucy first. My question is, why do we have to travel back and forth so much? The flowers weren't there the first time around.
Lucy, I know you're mad. But I know something that might cheer you up. Do you know a donkey named Cuckoo? Well, he's cuckoo over you. He gave me these flowers. For you.
Well, they seem to be interested in each other.
Lucy, won't you help me get out to that boat? A little girl may be in danger. Oh, hello. I was going to take a dip, but I'll check back later.
And how is...
Okay, let's get this crazy guy out to that fishing boat. And I'll give you one good leg, Lucy. Use it.
Well, we're on the boat.
Mind if I hitch a ride with you?
Not at all. Welcome aboard my fishing felucca. We're headed further into Upper Egypt towards the farming villages. Ha ha!
Perfection! Bye,
these guys Egyptian pirates.
Bye,
apparently.
Lucy!
I see. I was wondering who those guys are in the distance. And we have a fourth location in Egypt. I guess maybe they were trying to tell us their way of life. That hat at the back looks more Vietnamese than Egyptian. On the farmer, I mean. And this Pink again. He's coming. This right off the bat, we can see something here. Maybe something to pick up. Not as much.
Chione? I'm sorry, I thought you were.
Want to turn the side?
Oh no, I was just looking for someone.
The little buckets dump water into the ditch. We use it to irrigate the farm.
Oh, so you're in charge of irritating the farm.
Not irritate, irrigate.
I see, that's just swell. Say, do you know a little girl named Chione?
Her parents don't like her to turn the sake.
So you do know her. Has she been here?
Who is that?
You?
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to trespass. Is this your farm? Are you a farmer?
It is my farm, and I am a farmer. I also happen to sit on the People's Assembly, Egypt's legislative body. I'm an Aries. I enjoy water skin and mint gum.
I'm looking for a little girl named Chione.
I'm looking for someone to feed my birds, but you don't see me burdening you with my problems. Get it? Burdening.
Okay, now we need some bird seed for these guys.
Looks like someone's been working hard.
I doubt the bull has anything of value here.
Look, a little oven. Reminds me of my Betty Crocker Easy Bake. You should have tried my cuppy cakes to die for! Look, a little oven. Reminds me.
Okay, what do we.
Now, this is what I call waterfront property.
Well, it actually is a waterfront property.
Won't you help feed the birds? When you feed them, they put on quite a show.
And what do we feed them with? Where do we get the stuff to feed them? Oh, right. I forgot I picked this up. Maybe we can get something from... Or not. I was thinking we could get something from the farm, but of course that would be a little too simple. Of course, some dates.
This is no time to put my hoe down. A date palm tree. Wow, I haven't had a date in years, and I always thought I was rather attractive.
Alright, pick up these now. It's time to give them to the birds.
I'm a black-winged kite. I make my home chilling by the Nile. The other birds flock around me trying to bite off a piece of my style.
That's nice.
I'm a pied kingfisher. I dive into the Nile's water to catch my prey. I am an excellent provider, but the chicks still run away.
Why do all these folks rhyme? Anyhow, I guess we tried this bird here.
I am a lonely water bird. I'm the size of a chicken. I'm a purple gallinule with loads of ambition. Thank you very much.
I wonder why that one sort of looks like this word looks like it's stoned, you know. Thinking that's probably just my imagination. Let's go back and talk to that.
Thank you kindly. Now I'll be happy to answer any questions you have about Chione.
Have you seen her?
No.
Do you know where she might be?
No.
Can you think of anyone that might be able to help me?
Well, no.
Thanks. You've been very helpful.
Really?
No.
You're in such hot water, man!
It's like you're soaked.
Huh?
You know, because of the hot water and all.
So, what are we supposed to do here again?
Huh? You're going nowhere, Pink Legs.
Huh? There's no escape!
Huh? You're going nowhere, Pink Legs.
Now, is this the point for you to start using the code?
I'm surprised at you. That wouldn't be polite.
Huh? There's no escape!
Huh? You're going nowhere, Pink Legs.
Okay, so what do we use the code with? The God Radical one. There's something here. From the looks of it.
Huh? There's no escape!
Yeah, there's a bowl of salad up there. I guess we put the salad on top of the pizza there. No? That looks like pizza, maybe. I thought we could probably do something with that. Nothing can be done here, but what are we doing? Destroying the eagle?
I got a salad. Run.
How about Egyptian Nicki Minaj?
Yep, it's a salad.
Oh man, a salad? Man, I'm starved. I could really go for a salad, man, in a big way.
That didn't work out. So what do we use the salad for? The bowl? We can't interact with
the bowl
at all.
I'm a kid! What do you want me to do?
Good question, actually. What do I want a kid to do? I see.
Not just yet.
We stick a hole in the ground with the hole?
You're digging your own grave, Panther!
Not quite.
So what? You're trying to, like, tempt me with the salad, man? Is that what's going on?
No, Lily, it's so dangerous!
Just because, you know, I'm, like, really, really hungry, man.
Step away from the salad, Louie.
I gotta get it, man. I'm starving.
No!
Oh, man.
Perfectly good salad gone to waste.
Thank you. That was a boot.
The most impressive use of a salad I've ever seen. That's strange. We don't usually see many pigeons along the Nile.
Hey, what are you doing here?
I came to deliver a message.
How did you get all the way to Egypt?
How do you think I got here? I flew, for crying out loud. I am a bird. Sheesh.
But I thought you were afraid of...
Hello! Not in front of the foreign feathers, if you don't mind. Heavens to Purdue, what in Frank's name is that thing? You are huge!
I am a purple gallinule. I am a water bird.
You look more like a turkey to me, honey. You are truly massive.
So, what's the message you came to deliver?
You know, you have no tact. Did anyone ever tell you that? Sheesh, I mean, come on! How about a little privacy already?
Forgive my friend, would you mind excusing us?
Not at all. Tell the bird to keep in mind, pigeon is a delicacy in Egypt.
I do not like her. I just don't.
Please, what is the message about?
Dear little Chione, is she a love? I found this by the lake. She must have meant to mail it to her parents. I figured I'd do a good deed and bring it over for her.
Von Schmarty told me she was so miserable at camp, she ran away.
You don't say. Maybe this note has some information on her whereabouts.
Let me see it.
Not so fast, Pink Puff. I'm sure you must have picked up a little bubble along the way for me. Something so I know I'm loved. I am loved, aren't I?
And this would be the point where you give it the scarab. God with logic never ceases to amaze me.
A scarab! You care! You really care! I love it!
Oh no, it's in hieroglyphics!
What are you gonna do?
I'll try to find someone who can help decode this, I suppose.
Maybe this little girl here?
I can decode it for you. It says,
nice.
I am happy. She's having fun.
Fun? That doesn't make any sense. Von Schmarty said she was miserable. I better get back to that camp.
Wait, you better take this.
Thanks. Pink to Schmarty. Come in, Schmarty.
Pink, I found Chione. She came back to camp.
And she's happy, right?
No, she's more unhappy than ever.
More unhappy than ever? This doesn't make sense. I'll need jet transport back to Camp Chilliwawa immediately.
Okay, we're going back to Chilliwawa now. There it is. Well, the adventure in Egypt left me with more questions than answers. Oh damn, all the fish are dead.
I hate people from your country.
My country is better than your country.
People from your country are dumb.
People from your country are ugly.
And I guess we could talk to him then.
Thank goodness you've returned!
I found out some interesting stuff. It turns out Nigel...
The children are out of control! All of the supplies are missing! My airboards! My pogo shoes gone! Most of the food has disappeared, and the children aren't even eating what's left! They're angry and hateful! Something is very wrong! You must get to the bottom of this!
Well, something seems to be extremely wrong. The plot thickens. Well, for starters, there are dead fish in the water.
Did you bring anything back from your trip?
I did, in fact.
That's Nigel's doll. I'll give it to him when I see him.
I guess we could let us have the letters over to him.
Look, I found this postcard. It's signed Nigel, but it's filled with spelling mistakes. And Nigel's spelling is usually meticulous.
Yeah, and look at the postmark. It's dated before the camp even opened.
Interesting. Somebody's trying to sabotage this camp. Probably the people from the CBC and the hieroglyphics as well. I'm guessing that was a typographical error that they made.
Look at this note from Chione. It says,
Pink, not here. Something as sinister is surfacing. You better hide any of your clues under the loose boards in the supply shed.
Okay.
Alright, let's do that then. Nigel, I've got a gift for you. Anything to make you happy, son.
What's this?
That's your old friend, Guy Fawkes. Most of the kids in England burn their guy dummies, but not you. You love your...
You're ready to burn it, aren't you?
Guy Fawkes.
That's interesting.
Wo hen le yi, zai xin zhe, bu gei ni ren zheng hanbaga jian.
Wo hen le yi,
zai xin zhe, bu gei ni ren zheng hanbaga jian. Wo hen le yi, zai xin zhe, bu gei ni ren zheng hanbaga jian.
Do you want a hamburger, son? I thought he said hamburger, though. That's a code too. Well.
Secret hiding place. So this is where Von Schmarty said to hide stuff.
Yep. Now I'm finishing the game. Let's just hope that things won't get lost there. Ah, it's not deep. I thought it was like a bottomless pit or something. But it's not. It's apparently not. We go back out, then I suppose.
Don't chuck a wobbly, you boofhead!
And it's tucked on.
Von Schmarty!
Hi, where are you?
I'm in the tool shed.
Well, come out!
I'm stuck in here. Komokin locked me in.
Oh boy, be right there! Pink, we have to find young Lee. He's very upset.
Young Lee this time. But at this point, I'll just leave.
Please, Pink, find Young Lee!
Young Lee or Young Lee? I don't know why I just ran off a lap of the camp there. Maybe you were trying to find Young Lee. Anyhow, I'll just leave things right here, and we will get back to Young Lee and China the next time we get back